Hello, my name's Noel Jones. I'm the son of one of the joint founders of a company called Jones Bailers Limited, which was based in Rosesmore on the site of an abandoned lead mine since 1911. Having had a contracting business going around farms before the war, they continued that during the war by compulsion, because Britain needed home production of food for the population. When the war started, they found that their machines were now becoming unreliable and they needed more. We were in Wales, however, much of all the requirements we needed for tools and parts were located in Merseyside and towards Manchester. So this bridge figured very highly in the activities of this very small company. So here we are in 1942, a rotten year for Britain. No money, no military, the Atlantic causing endless sinkings, no grain from Canada, all the parkland in Britain ploughed up in order to grow grain. We had no men, no money, no spares. Everything was worn out. We cannibalized everything to try and make things work, but we really were up against it and had no assistance from the government. We were a small outfit, and every small outfit in Britain had to make stuff for the war effort. It was compulsory. There was no spare availability of metal or money or staff or anything, and there was no fuel. There were no vehicles. Nothing had been produced, and there we were, a little firm on our own with no knowledge and no experience, and we were up against it. We have to emphasize is the difficulty of finding things that we needed to make these machines, which were primarily in England. Some were obviously from Wales, but an awful lot was from England. And in order to get to there, we had to cross this bridge. It wasn't difficult to cross it, however, we weren't allowed. Why not? There was a big policeman over there checking, is your journey really necessary, sir? To which you had to have an answer. And he had all day, because there was no traffic, there was no fuel and no purpose. And all the men were at war, bar our little outfit up in Rosesmere, who wished to cross this bridge and come back when they were stuck for further materials. The key person who resolved this problem was my uncle David, who was the joint founder of this little firm. He had a small piggery, and this was exempt from rationing because nobody knew about it. And this was magic, because nobody had any fresh food when they really wanted it. But from the countryside and close to his house and close to the little works, he did have these pigs and probably a few chickens and maybe a few eggs as well. He could get anything and he could talk. So he decided to chat up the security man so that whenever they needed something or to cross, they had an answer. Please remember me when I come back, because when you look in the back of the van, there may be something that is of interest that you wish to check out. As simple as that. And they regularly did it. They were able to get the bits that they want in their little van across this bridge into their works and do their bit for the war effort. The business of Jones Bailers continued. It worked for us, and we were able to carry on with our individual little bit for winning the war for Britain. If you're looking for further information on the history of Jones Bailers, it is all in this little book here, which was published about 5 years ago, and everything in there is true.